Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Jacob, and today I'm gonna be showing 5 super obvious features that you either knew your whole life or you discovered them just now after 3,000 years of using 3ds Max. So let's dive deeper into the known unknown depths of 3ds Max. Our first feature is gonna be paint soft selection. So whenever you're in editable poly and you go to, I don't know, vertex mode, you can activate your standard soft selection, and here you have the paint button. So when you click it, you're gonna get like a brush, and now you can literally start painting your soft selections. Additionally, you can even blur these selections. So look, you can like blur the areas, or if you click on the revert button, this will be like an eraser, so you can like erase stuff. And now if you go to your move tool, you can actually start designing some nice paths for your, I don't know, river or something like that. And once you're done, you can actually notice that the selection will kind of stay active. Even if I go to the polygon mode and I, for example, select a polygon, it will still bring up the, you know, the current selection that we have. So in order to remove this selection, just unclick the lock soft selection button. And now you can start playing with your other modeling maneuvers. Our next feature is going to be lock UI layout. So how many times did it happen to you that, for example, you want to click the undo button and you just misclick and do this, and then you start to, you know, like move things in the correct order? Or you go to the curve editor, and while repositioning the curve editor, it just gets, you know, snapped on wrong places, etc. Well, what you can do, you can go to customize and you have a lock UI layout. And now you have literally prevented Max to dock anything anywhere. Look, even if I want to, you know, move these, it's not going to happen. Move these, it's not gonna happen. And this way, you just prevented your Max to become a live disco whenever you wanna move things around. Our next feature is gonna be preview selection in editable poly. So I'm talking about this section here. Not many people know what these two buttons do, the sub object and multi, but let me quickly show you. If I click on the sub object, so what it does, whenever I hover my mouse over some polygons, you can notice that these polygons turn yellow. But now, if I hold the control button and just start dragging around, you can see that I'm making this, you know, yellow like selection. And when I just click my mouse button, you can see that that selection actually becomes an active selection. The same thing goes with the edge mode. So for example, you can see that like edges are being selected. And now, of course, if I just hold control and just, you know, swipe around, etc., do the click, this turns into a selection. And our third feature here is multi. So what does multi do? It literally allows you to see all your selections across vertex, edge, and polygon mode at the same time. So for example, I'm just going to turn off the preview selection. So if I select a bunch of polygons here, and then I go to the edge mode, and then I select a bunch of edges here, and then I go to the vertex mode, and I'm going to select a bunch of vertices here. If I go to the multi, you can see all those selections. Of course, the brightest one is the one that's currently active. So if I go to the edge mode, you know, I'm going to see this. And if I go to my polygon mode, I'm going to see these. But there is a catch with this. So look at this now. I'm in my polygon mode, multi is selected, and when I zoom in, you can see how the polygons get the yellow selection. But you can also notice, if I go to the edge, you can see how edge also got a yellow selection. So polygon, edge, vertex. And from this point, I can literally start selecting, literally just pressing the control button, I can do the selection of the polygons, and then, for example, I go to the edge here, do the control click, and I can do the edge selections. And now you can notice that the polygon selection got dimmer because edge mode is now active. Activated. And now if I want to do a vertex, I'm just gonna position my mouse over the vertex and just do the control button and just make a random selection and do the click, and now my vertices are gonna be selected. And that's generally preview selection. So you can do these multi selections while holding the control button. Of course, you do not need to use any of that. You can just do your normal regular selections, but in the multi view, you can always see what selection you have on your polygon base, on edge base, on vertex base. So yeah, it's a cool pretty little feature. Our next feature is local aligned reference coordinate system. Now, I'm talking about this one. Like when you go to the reference coordinate system, you have views, screen, world, local, blah, blah, and you have local aligned. So I use this coordinate system mostly when I'm modeling stuff, because what it does is going to orient your pivot based on your, you know, polygon selections. So for example, if I want to select a couple of polygons, let's say, you know what, I'm going to be smart about it, and I'm going to activate the sub object mode. So if I want to, let's say, make this selection, and if I want to move this selection like in a Z direction of, you know, of the selected polygons, it's going to be kind of hard to do that in the view mode. Local will do something similar, but not quite. But in that case, you can just switch to your local aligned, and then your pivot will be perfectly aligned to your polygon selection. And now you can do, you know, extrudes or whatever you want to do. So that's the feature that I actually use quite a lot. I just did one modification with Max's hotkeys. So I've rebound a local aligned to my Y button and view to my Q button. Because in my general workflow, I'm mostly using the view reference coordinate system, but whenever I need to model stuff, I'm switching between those two a lot. So for example, if I make a selection like this and I'm in my view mode, I can just press Y button and it's gonna be shifted. If I need to go back to the view, just press the Q and it goes back to the view. This last part about hotkeys is generally a personal preference, but yeah. In our last feature, I generally thought that everyone knows about this, but apparently a lot of people still don't. So, and that's the float viewports. So if you go to the top left of your viewport, click the little plus icon, you have float viewport here. Now you can choose three of them, but take a look at this. I'm just gonna press number two. And what do you get? You get this extra window as a viewport. And the cool thing is, you can literally maximize this viewport on your second monitor if you have one, and you can have this one giant viewport. Or if you want to be turbo crazy, and let's say this is your left monitor and this is your right monitor, you can go here, press Alt W, and then, you know, have your all four viewports being shown and four viewports here, and you can like be an octa viewport user, like how freaking hardcore or stupid that is. But if we ignore that, there's also an addition to this kind of feature. If you also click the plus button, you have the presentation mode. So the presentation mode, look at this. If I like maximize this, you know, floating viewport, if you click on the plus button and click on the presentation mode, it's gonna hide all the features, and you can like showcase this to whoever you are presenting stuff, you know. And if you just need to get out of it, you can, you know, just go with your mouse button to the top left and you're gonna see your options being shown here, and just turn off presentation mode. And as always, don't forget to check out EverMotion website, because they always have some offers. Look at this. Arc Models Volume 289, 42 sets of foods are now 25% off. So, are you feeling hungry? Like, look at these all delicious breakfast products here. You can have them in your 3D scene, and then that will make your client drool even more over your sexy renders. Check out EverMotion website. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye!